and welcome back to Bookworm! It's party day since its second series and the first video. We will be reading Harry Potter, Year One or Book One, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. I will show you the picture on the cover. We also have a new studio since its second series. It's much bigger, but we won't show you all around it. Much smaller if you count all this space. See, we have our new helpers, Hedwig and Squirmy Wormy.
Hi!
Since we have a new series, we need new special helpers, don't we? Okay, let's get started. We will do where it starts. It starts when Uncle Vernon and Aunt Petunia get Harry as a baby at their doorstep. Then he grows up until he's 10. It's almost his birthday, and he has a younger or older? I can't remember. So he has a cousin, and he is with his aunt and uncle, which are very mean to him. They don't like him. They make him do all the chores. They never celebrate his birthday, but they celebrate Dudley's. Then Harry gets a note, but they absolutely don't like it because they don't like wizarding, and he doesn't know he's a wizard yet. Letters keep coming and keep coming until they flee the house with none of Harry's belongings, almost all of Dudley's, and Uncle Vernon tells them they have to move to an old shack near the water, but the letters keep on coming. That time, Hagrid, Harry's friend, but not his friend yet. He comes and delivers the letter by hand. Oh, and then he's a giant, so he had to crash open the. He had to knock over the door to come in. He brought a cake in for Harry. He might have sat on it a few times, since the box was bent and wrinkly, and the letters were written in green ink. Hagrid wrote it. Then Hagrid gives Dudley a pigtail because he was already too much of a pig to turn him into a full pig. And then there is Hogwarts. They have to ride the Hogwarts Express. They have to go through a wall to get there though. They get their stuff before that though. They get their stuff. Harry's very first birthday present was Hedwig. No, like very, very first, because he never got his birthday celebrated. And then he goes to Hogwarts on a magical train where he meets his very best friend, Ron. I will tell you about him a little later. When he meets up with Hermione, she is very smart, and they think she's too smart to be their friend. But when they save her, I won't tell you what from though, when they save her, she becomes one of his second best friend. Ron and Hermione don't get along though, except when they, well, I don't remember how they get to like each other, but let's keep going. Then they have a nice big feast. Oh, and sorting. Sorting is one of my favorite parts, which I will tell you more about right now. Sorting is where they have a hat, a very dirty, wrinkly hat that's been there for over 1,000 years. And then pencils stay there. I told you to stay there, pencils. Sorting, the sorting hat goes over their heads and tells them one of four houses that they can go to. Well, not actual houses. First is Ravenclaw, second, Hufflepuff, then,
Slytherin?
Yes, Slytherin, Squirmy Wormy, and then
Gryffindor.
Gryffindor. Squirmy Wormy, you are good at those last two. I am not. I'm good at the first two. Okay, so the classes.
Do they sort them by?
Oh, they sort them by the hat is talking. It calls out what house they should be in at the very end of sorting. Well, not the very end, just at the end of their sorting time.
And then those are the houses that they live in, or the groups of people they're with the rest of the time?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Harry, Ron, and Hermione were picked in the same house, but of course Hermione wasn't their friend yet.
Which house did they get into?
They got picked in Gryffindor. Okay, should we go to classes now? Okay, classes. He first learns about his biggest enemy, Voldemort. Second biggest enemy, though, is Malfoy, which I'll tell you a little more about later. Classes is where they find out Professor Snape is not very nice, but he tries to repay his debt to Harry's father by protecting him. Harry and Hermione think that it's him doing all the damage to Harry, but it's actually someone sharing their body with Lord Voldemort. I shouldn't say his name, though. Okay. Should I move on or no? Okay. The duel. It's a midnight duel between Harry and Malfoy. I think now is the time to tell you more about Malfoy. Malfoy is from Slytherin, and his father worked for Voldemort. His family said they were controlled by him, but we know they were not. They were some that were just good to Voldemort and loyal, but not as loyal as someone you will meet in a few other books. Ron has a pet mouse that I won't tell you about yet, just yet. Maybe we'll get to some other books of Harry Potter, who knows? The 10th video, you know, we always do a competition, which I will have to think more about. And then, what should we do next? Are we done with duel? Oh, no, we're not done with duel. We will learn about duel more right now. Stay there. The duel is a midnight duel that Malfoy challenged Harry to, but he never showed up. And that naughty, naughty Malfoy. But Harry, Ron, and Hermione almost get caught by the hall monitor. He has a cat. I can't remember his name right now. Filch, that's his name. And he has a cat that is his faithful assistant. Oh, like my Miss Dwight. She is busy right now. All right, and they have to hide in a room where Hagrid's three-headed, giant three-headed dog guards a trap door that leads to the Sorcerer's Stone. We'll tell you more about that a little later. Alright. Do we move on now? Oh, yeah. They run to their house. They can't remember the password, I don't think. I don't remember, really. But I don't think they remember the password. But then then Hermione says it, and then they all get back in bed. They go to sleep. And then I'll tell you about the mirror they saw a few nights before. The mirror is where Harry sees his parents. He doesn't actually see them, but that's what he wants most, so he's just sad, and so he sees them, and two nights in a row he goes there. One night with Ron, three nights. And Professor Dumbledore shows up on the third night and tells him that he shouldn't use the mirror anymore.
Why?
So he doesn't get to see his parents anymore. But we'll find out why. Wait. And the sorcerers. He'll find out more about that in the end, which I'm not going to tell you because the end is the best part. Well, scary, but the best.
How old should people be to be reading this
at
book?
At least seven.
At least seven?
Seven or older.
Did your brother like it, who's five?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But did some parts scare him a little bit? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm Maddie's brother.
Bookworm. All right. I will save the ending. I think it's now time for the beans.
Tell them about Birdie Bot's beans. What are they?
The Birdie Bot's beans are
made by robot birdies.
That's not right. He just likes to be silly like any other small worm. And those... which one would I like?
What kinds of Birdie Bot's beans are there?
There are banana, black pepper, blueberry, booger, candy floss, cherry, cinnamon, dirt, earthworm, earwax, grass, green apple, marshmallow, rotten egg, sewage, lemon, soap, and tutti frutti, vomit, watermelon. So let's get started. Scummy wormy, here's your grass. I brought a trash can if you don't want it.
What kind did you eat?
Lemon.
Let's see your face, Charlie. Or squirmy wormy. Is it good? You like the grass? Which kind do you not like?
I do not like soap, rotten egg, dirt, earthworm, earwax, grass, booger, black pepper. I do like banana though. Not cinnamon. That's a cinnamon stick cinnamon. I do not like sewage. I do... I do not like vomit. I kind of like tutti frutti. And I might like watermelon. Who knows? Alright.
More!
I love the book so much. It's my favorite book of the year. And there's lots of crafts that I can do. And I will also be making some fried tea meals. Found out from the Harry Potter cookbook, which Hedwig is sitting on. Now, where was I? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.